Here we are across from Wrigley Field, and yes, we got the pitchforks. Okay, here I am, Columbus Avenue, downtown Chicago. Headed to the Wrigley Field, Cubs A's. Check out the architecture. It's pretty amazing around here. We're gonna be taking a little boat tour later. Getting ready to go to Wrigley Field. We're on Grand, and we're gonna go right there to Addison. Clark and Addison, baby. There's Billy Williams, one of the greatest Cub players of all time. And Ron Santo. Ron Santo loved the Cubs so much, he just got in the Hall of Fame, but he died of cancer not too long. Well, he had diabetes. It was actually diabetes. Yeah, and those are the seats you see on TV. The Wrigley rooftops. Here are the workers going into work. Here at Wrigley Field on Sheffield Avenue. There's Bill Buckner. I got his batting helmet. One of my friends was a ball boy. Sammy Sosa. This street here is called Waveland Avenue. This is where all the home runs go. Sammy Sosa. Mark McGuire. Did Chuck? He's coming. Okay, so the wind looks like it's blowing a little bit in today. Okay, here I am on Waveland Avenue. And this is where Dave Kingman hit one of the longest home run shots in Cubs history at Wrigley Field. It's the longest home run. It went down, bounced down that field. And there's the top of the bleachers out of the stadium.
Hey, kiss him goodbye. It is gone. Oh, I thought he hit the other one high. That one's in Milwaukee. It hit the front porch of the third house across Waveland Avenue.
And now we're coming up to the big famous firehouse that you see before all the games. They always show the firehouse and the Dalmatians sitting out in the front. Player entrance right here. There's the old firehouse. This is the players come in here through the entrance here. They're waiting for them. Hey Chuck, this is where the players come in. This is why everyone's gathered around. Here we are in the Cubs team shop. All Cubs stuff. That's awesome. Greg Maddux, Golden Glove. Ryan Sandberg. Oh, Ryan Sandberg's got a whole bunch here. Andre Dawson, Don Kessinger, you know. We're just gonna walk to the front. We're gonna see look at this one. Look at that big scoreboard. Yeah. All right, let's play two. Ernie Banks right there. Ernie Banks, Mr. Cub. We don't have to go back through there, we can just walk around it. So we don't have to go to the Here we are across from Wrigley Field, and yes, we got the pitchforks. They're raising the pitchforks up here, ladies and gentlemen. And our waitress is from Tucson. And it took her 10 minutes to figure out what that was. She didn't want to see it, but it's there, man.
I spotted it.
Wrigley Field. It's happening, baby. Here we are inside Wrigley Field. The friendly confines, home at last. Yeah, here we are, Wrigley Field. Like it? It's awesome. Upper deck to check out the views.
She's got the mentality.
Yeah.
Okay, here I am
One of the worst seats at Wrigley Field, right here.
As you can see, I'm way up here, really high. Thank goodness these aren't my seats. But still, pretty awesome. I would take these for any World Series game, definitely. You got the bleacher bums, you got the bleacher rooftops on the top.
Okay, Chuck pulled the big surprise on me. He told me we were going to be in the upper level, but he actually got lower level seats, so I'm really excited.
I'm like, where are we going? I go, this isn't where our seats are. But they are. Even with third base bag, the friendly confines, Wrigley Field, you gotta love it.
Yeah.
W. The
Cubs went 10-1 in front of a 41,000 at Wrigley Field. Great game. This is my seventh game at Wrigley Field, my first victory. Six straight losses, and now I finally get a victory.
And Kelly and Chuck got to see it.
Yep.
All right. Good evening.